more about their work, would you please welcome Eran Segev?
Yay!
But first, we're going to just review the winners of the Australian Skeptics Annual Awards.
The Australian Skeptics Annual Awards were presented at last night's gala dinner.
Or gala dinner, as your insisted on calling it.
No award was made for the Skeptic of the Year, although there were many worthy contenders. Their work is still in progress, so it was decided to hold that award over until 2016.
The Thornett Award went to vaccine advocates Catherine and Greg Hughes, whose baby Riley tragically died from whooping cough in March this year.
And in a wildly popular decision, the Best Food Award for the perpetrator of the most preposterous piece of pseudoscientific pebble, that was great alliteration, was Paleo Pete Evans. Why don't we join together by blowing a big skeptical raspberry to Paleo Pete?
That felt good.
Blowing raspberries is pretty therapeutic, in fact.
Yeah, we'll have to check the veracity of that with Loretta Marin, I think. And now, Eran, would you like to tell us some more about the Australian Skeptics?
Thanks, Chris. Thanks, Jake. Australian Skeptics Inc. is the New South Wales organisation of Australian Skeptics. Since 1986, we have been responsible for a variety of national activities as well as the local activities. Those include the publication of the Skeptic magazine, which you can subscribe to with Tim. Is Tim here?
Yep.
Okay. We have been coordinating the conventions and the awards that you've just heard about, and generally serving as a hub for skeptical activity in Australia. For the past 20 years, thanks to bequests left to the organisation, we have the ability to support activities also financially through the Australian Skeptics Science and Education Foundation. We also employ the only professional skeptic in Australia, Tim Mendham. Tim, could you stand for a second? Tim was editor of the magazine a long time ago when many of you were just a theory. But he came back in 2009 and has been the executive officer of Australian Skeptics and the editor of the magazine since. And we hope that he will continue to be for many more years. Due to these circumstances, we are able to offer significant support to skeptics who need it. The support can be administrative or organizational in nature, or it can be advice from our past experience. For example, the Brisbane Skeptic Society, when they were organizing, they started a year ago to organize this convention, we handed over all our notes and documents and templates from past conventions and had sessions with them to give them advice. Or the support can be financial, such as we regularly underwrite the conventions. We also provide, we have a system for providing grants for activities of importance. There are organized skeptical groups in most states and territories, probably all, I would say. And more than one, actually, in some localities. For example, Melbourne, there's a proliferation of skeptical groups in Melbourne. And these groups, some of these groups nationally are more or less active. Some of them are very active, some of them are not so active. Some of them are just monthly or less than monthly meetings in a pub. Others do a lot of outreach work. But we work with as many of those organizations as would work with us to try to help them increase their reach and their appeal, especially to a younger audience. The major change we've experienced over the last decade, of course, has been that through the internet, there are now many more active skeptics who are not part of the traditional established groups, and that was actually one of the reasons that there's a proliferation of groups in some places. But these skeptics, while not directly affiliated, are nonetheless very active. Our goal is to increase skeptical activity. So it is important to us to be aware of local activities and private initiatives so that we can assist and help in making sure that they're successful to the extent possible. If you have an idea or you're already involved in an activity and you need assistance of any kind, please contact us. We'd love to help you. If, like most people, you don't have an individual initiative, but you want to help other people's initiatives, please join us. You can subscribe to the magazine, as I mentioned. You can go to Tim and subscribe now, or you can subscribe online. We have printed and digital versions of the magazine. You can go to our website, and we are going to launch a new supporters program very shortly. And you can already go to our website, look for Support Us, and you can register, and you will receive our new newsletter, and you will also receive information on how to become a supporter. And some of the ways to support us will include financial support, but it will also include support in providing expertise and help in other ways. Another thing you can do is you can buy a shirt. And it's not so much for the money, because we're actually selling them at cost at the moment. So please go and buy a shirt. The shirts with the Skeptics logo are a great conversation starter. And it gives you an opportunity to talk about skepticism to just people who wonder what this strange logo is all about. And of course, you can and should join a local group. Become involved in whatever way you can, if it's just to drink and spend some time with fellow skeptics, or get involved in more profound and long-reaching activities. All of these things are good and important. Please do that. And just generally, be involved. Australia needs you. Thank you very much.